We thought of drawing the graph. Can we say whether given equations are consistent or inconsistent or dependent? Okay, this is the idea, okay? So we generalize the idea. Intersecting, then m by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. Coincident, then all ratios are equal. And parallel, the constant, the ratios of constant are not matching. Ratios of x coefficients and y coefficients are equal. Okay. And there's one problem here in textbook, example number 4. Okay. Equations are given. So we found two solutions for each and we drew the graph. Graphs are intersecting. Graphs are intersecting. You simply verify this result, that is a1 by, if intersecting, then a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. So simply check in this problem, what will be by these two equations are here. So a1 by a2, what will be a1 by a2? What will be a1 by a2 in this?
Half. Problem? 1 by 2.
Yes. What will be b1 by b2?
Minus 1 by
1 by minus 1, right? So the ratios are not equal. 1 by 2 is not equal to 1 by minus 1. Okay. So the if not equal, then the graphs will be intersecting, right? Intersecting. That's what you can see in this picture. The graphs are intersecting at one point. And the 6,0 will be the solution for pair of equations. Given two pair of equations. So when question comes, most of the time the question will be intersecting graphs. The question is to solve pair of equation. Most of the time will be, if you want to solve using geometrical method, most of the time it will be an intersecting graph. A1 by A2 will not be equal to B1 by B2. And there will be exactly one intersecting point. That will be the solution for both pair of equations. In this case, 6,0 is the solution for this pair of equations. Okay. And solve them graphically. Solve means you want to find the intersecting point. That intersecting point will be the solution for the pair of equation. And if you draw this, if you write the answer to this question, final step should be 6,0 is the solution for the pair of equations. Okay. And in the next graph, you can see two equations are given. Before showing the graph, can you tell whether this equation are intersecting or parallel or coinciding? Just compare the ratios of coefficients. The second equation you can rewrite like this. Second equation you can rewrite like this. So equation number 1 here and equation number 2 here. Say first equation is here and second equation is here. The given second equation we rewrite like this by multiplying 5 by 3. Take the ratios of coefficients of x and coefficients of y. Are they equal? Yes, they are equal, right? 5 by 1. So I shall write here. The ratios of coefficients of x are 5 by 5. 5 by 5 is 1. The ratios of coefficients of y are minus 8 by minus 8. That is also 1. So these two graphs are not intersecting. We fix that. Okay. Now also check for the constant terms. What's that? 1 by 1. Okay. So 1 by 1 is also 1. So which case?
Coincident.
So the graphs will be coincident. The graph is not given here in this case. The fifth x solution is not given here. Okay. And you want to say, if the question is to solve, you want to say every point on the line are solutions. Okay. Then the fifth equation you can see here. Just check the ratios. Just check the ratios.
No. Yes.
Intersecting, right? Intersecting. Yes. Okay, so yes. Ratios, are the ratios of x coefficients and y coefficients equal?
No.
They are not equal. The x coefficients are 2 and 4. So the ratio is 2 by 4. 2 by 4. And ratios of y coefficients, if you move y to right side, it will be minus 1. Minus 1 by minus 1 is simply 1 by 1 or 1. Okay, and here it is 1 by 2, and they are not equal. So the graphs will intersect. A 1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. So the graphs will be intersecting one, and it is given here. The graphs are given here. They are intersecting, and the intersecting point will be the solution for pair of equations. So in the final step, you want to write 1, 0 is the solution of pair of equation. Okay, and I wind up the lesson here and see you next time. Bye.